from the high desert of Southern California and on the web at praiseyahuwah.com, announcing the kingdom of Yahuwah. And now it's time for truth with your servant host, Denya Cajaliero.
And a very warm, loving welcome to you, dear friends, from myself, Denya, and my wife, Dia. We thank you for joining us here this evening. Thank you for those listening live and those who are also listening via YouTube and our cloud storage space. We are so encouraged because the broadcast that we had last week, amazing revelation there with the Gospel of Peter, as it's called. There were about 500 of you in a week in total that decided to download and listen or join us live. And so for all of you and those who are congregating with you throughout the face of this earth to listen to us, we thank you so much. It's encouraging to know that there are truth seekers out there who care about the truth, that the truth truly does matter as much as it does to Dia and myself. Well, we don't look at the amount of people who listen or download, whether it be in the hundreds or the thousands. That's not how we calculate our relevance. Our relevance here is that we proclaim Yahuwah's great name and his kingdom because this is the least that we should do for him. And we're grateful, however, that there's so many of you that enjoy these coins of value. They're not put under a basket. They may not be popular in the world, but rest assured that those of you who join us in understanding the things that Yahuwah has given us, those of you who appreciate truth rather than political correctness or popularity, you are truly our brother and our sister in Yahuwah, our family in Yahuwah. And we know that it is a very lonely road, very lonely. There's no kahals, for the most part, no congregations, none of these gatherings that will agree to test these things and then to cling to that which is truthful and good. But you do, and we're thankful for you. We're grateful for you. And we praise Yahuwah, and we know that Yahuwah, his light shines upon you and upon us for exploring all that he has to give us. Friends, nothing short of excellent information that Yahuwah has yet again provided to us. And we've compiled today some very interesting information that Yahuwah has given us in the hour of our need this day, and also with the things that we have learned through the years. We're going to be discussing Christmas, and this is an appropriate time of year to really think about this, and we're going to be also offering this on the YouTube channel with more of a video to it that we don't generally do. We generally just have one video type of picture background while you listen on YouTube, but this time we want to put some pictures and some things that we've compiled in a set apart way, Kodesh way, so that it can be shared. There's lots of things out there about the paganistic practices understood in the roots of Christmas, and yet a lot of the videos we found are fortunately and unfortunately, coming from various sources that have not yet learned the name of Yahuwah, the true importance of his covenant. They're just starting to break through the understandings of things when it comes to holidays and paganistic ways and means. So we're going to compile that so that there is something that can be spread through the internet in a set-apart way, without the pagan names, Zeus names and Hova names and so forth. So we look forward to getting that on the web, YouTube site live and on the website as well, or not live, but rather recorded so that people can go in and watch at their convenience. And also today we're going to discuss something absolutely wonderful that Yahuwah has given us a second long-awaited confirmation to. And I know that many of you have been waiting for it since we hinted about it last week. Our plate was full last week. Our plate is full this week. I'm not sure if we can get to Enoch today in our reading of the prophets, but we're certainly hopeful that we can. But if we can't, if our 2 hours is full, we praise Yahuwah for a wonderful, magnificent bounty and smorgasbord of spiritual food that we're going to have today. And we know that both things that Yahuwah has given us today to share will bless you, bless your family and friends. First, friends, let us Shema together. It's our form of prayer and thanksgiving in a way. Although we do pray to Yahuwah for his blessings daily and especially before the broadcast that he be with us. But as a group, whether you're listening live or recorded together in our ruach, personal ruachs that we all have, let us Shema together from Deuteronomy 6, 3 through 6. Hear, or Shema, that's what Shema means. Hear, therefore, Yasserah, and observe to do it, that it may be well with you, that you may increase mightily as Yahuwah, Almighty loving Yah of all creation of your fathers, has promised to you, to a land flowing with milk and honey. Hear, O Yasserah, Yahuwah is your Almighty loving Yah of all creation. Yahuwah is your only Almighty One. You shall love Yahuwah, Almighty loving Yah of all creation, with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your very being. These covenant words which I restore to you this day shall forever be on your heart. So we're listening, are we not? We're Shemaing together this day, and thankful of his covenant words that we reflect upon daily. Well, the great Sabbath that we follow up with the Shema, which is the Sabbah, or the response by Ephraim, his people, you and I, the grafted in, praise Yahuwah, alleluia. We hear you, great Yahuwah. Yahuwah, you are our almighty loving Yah of all creation. Yahuwah, you are our only almighty one. We pledge to love you, great Yahuwah, almighty loving Yah of all creation, with all our heart and all our mind and all our very being. The covenant words which you have given us this day shall always be on our heart. And we worship you, Almighty Yahuwah, and no other. We call upon your set-apart name, Amani Yahuwah. That means, friends, we believe in Yahuwah. It's not just an amen, it's an Amani. We believe in the ancient tongue, Amani Yahuwah. And so we do. And it's fitting then that with that Shema, we think about walking in his covenant way, what it means to us, that we reflect upon it daily, that we love Yahuwah daily, we think about him daily, we praise him daily, we pray for others daily. Many of you that Dee and I know, we pray for you daily because we know that the evil one is constantly out there seeking to destroy, to tear apart, to place doubt, to cause people to waver in their understandings. When Dee and I first came to know Yahuwah, this was back in 2009, that summer. We dedicated our lives September around the festival there, right at, I believe, and we praised Yahuwah for his great name. And we were just learning the total importance of his covenant. It was so new to us. And there were so many things we were hearing. We've talked about this before, that we were torn about many different things. But Yahuwah made so much clear over time the great things that he had in store for us in our walk, the freedom of Yahuwah, the truth of him, so that we're not reprobate, so that we're not doubtful, so we don't have others cause us to be branded with things of men, but rather that which Yahuwah, that through the sending of his Son, wanted us to know about and to declare and to walk in and to grow up in as his children. Well, one of the things that we learned that year, that first year, is that the scriptures are very different from translation to translation. And the more we went back further and further and further in what tools we all have available, the more that we were able to figure out the truth of things. And we found that the truth of things, clearer and clearer to us, were for many, it seemed to be a stumbling block. It seemed to be they were so caught up in the tradition and traditions of what they were taught in their churches, in their kingdom halls, in their synagogues and temples, and all these different places of worship, that they still had this baggage as they abided in the name and were learning the covenant, but yet would not still reject the fact that the Bibles are extremely leavened, just as Jeremiah, just as Hezekiah, just as Yahshayahu, just as our own Savior and his disciples taught. Well, we learned early on that we had seen a translation of Galatians 5, 22 and 23. And as a kid, I grew up and as a Jehovah's Witness, and I was taught the fruitages of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, da-da-da-da-da-da-da, right? There's nine of them, according to the world. And in that understanding, there were actually three of those nine that I knew my whole life seemed to be repetitive. Like I would read that scripture and I'd say, well, wait a minute, these three fruits that are in this translation of the quote unquote Holy Scriptures, they're the same as these other three. So really there's only six fruitages here. I don't understand that. It doesn't make sense. But, well, you know, the Lord works in mysterious ways, right? Isn't that what you were taught? Well, come to find out, Lord means Baal and all these other twistings in Bible that were changed, which we had our eyes opened up to, and including Galatians 5, 22 and 23. Well, as I read in this one translation, which was called OSC 1 at that time, and it was mysteriously from some, found somewhere, these amazing scrolls that were never revealed, and the people were quite hidden, and it was very mysterious by this one who supposedly had, you know, been let in on this great big secret. We found that the fruitages of the Spirit in that were 12 based on that scripture, and I thought, wow, that does ring of truth only because I knew of the repetition in all the other translations that I had known of. And I'll say that I had known of, and we'll be getting to that more on that in a minute. And I thought this rings of truth somehow, because 12 and 7 in things that Yahuwah and 10, there are specific calculations, if you will, balances of things. Everything in our life is a balance and a calculation, and Yahuwah's fingerprint is upon everything, is it not? But I knew, I said, you know, this rings of truth, but I just don't know. I just don't know what I don't know. I'm going to have to test all things in this. I'll take it on faith. I'll take it at its face. And as I began to read the Bible and the scriptures over and over and over, it became clear to me that there were 12 fruits, in fact. They were different from the 12 that I had learned originally. I was led by Yahuwah to understand that there were 12 specific things in scripture that I found over and over and over. And as I spent, as I was going to sleep, before I went to sleep and I would do my reading in scripture, which I found was my favorite time to read the word, I read over and over the 12 types of fruits, and I had these in the back of my mind. One day I started to write them down. I said, well, this is predominant in scripture. okay, this is similar, and this is the same as what I was originally taught. This is the same as what I came to learn. And then this is different and newer light, greater truth, and full understanding based on reading the scriptures over and over. What I found was that there were 12 clear fruits. And I praised Yahuwah for that, but I didn't quite know in my heart. Are there really 12 fruits? One day, reading of scripture, Yahuwah led me to Revelation 22, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And I'd read that so many times before. Especially, I read Revelation more so than all the times that I'd gone through the Bible completely. And so I'd read this, but it never was clear. And it's an example, friends, of how Yahuwah makes things clearer to us. The more we study, the more he makes crystal clear the truth. So I read Revelation, and one day in 22, the light finally went on. Well, I talked to you about this before. It reads that he showed me a river of the water of life. The water of life, friends. Clear as crystal. See, friends, when I tell you that it became crystal clear, it literally says it right here, does it not? It says, coming from the throne of Eloah Ya'am and of the Lamb. In the middle of its street, on either side of the river, was the tree of life, which bore 12 fruits. The light went on, friends, and I realized, oh my Yahuwah. Look at this. And then it says, as a second witness, each tree yielding a fruit for every month. There's a 12 confirmation again, friends. It says, and the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. You see, friends, leaves, the figurative aspect of leaves is life itself, friends. Without leaves, a tree cannot grow, produce fruit, and take the energy from the sun that Yahuwah provides, right? And likewise, these fruitages of the Spirit, friends, they're the very leaves of your strength, of your healing, friends. Without these leaves being practiced in your heart and your mind, you can't grow, you can't heal, you can't create fruit. And so Yahuwah was making it clear that this scripture in Revelation was exactly the fruitage of the Spirit. There, in fact, were 12. And I thought, wow. But then it says, they were for the healing of the nations. No longer shall there be any curse. See, friends, we have generational curses. We have curses from our religious orders we've grown up with. We have constant demonic activity around us when we're in the world. But in Yahuwah, he gives us another example of how you get rid of all these things. People say, how do I get rid of this affliction and that affliction and these problems? Go straight to the pharmacy of Yahuwah, which is truly no sorcery at all. It is his love potion, if you will. It is Yahuwah's gift to us for healing. But are we practicing each fruit? And possibly, if we are enduring some sort of problem right now, physical, mental, or otherwise, more than likely, I will tell you right now, as hard as it is a pill to swallow, and no matter where you are in your walk with Yahuwah, one of these 12 fruits is lacking. You're not getting the full healing of Yahuwah. There's a curse still attacking you. You see, it says further in verse 3 of 22, that in the throne of Eloah Ya'am, and the Lamb shall be in it, and his servants shall serve him. They shall see his face, and his name shall be on their foreheads. Alleluia. Now, we know fruits are 12, but beyond this, where's the proof? In the original scripture. I never saw it, other than supposedly another man supposedly found it in some scrolls that were supposedly somewhere from someone that never came to fruition, at least not yet. And certainly there were things that heavily conflicted to show that there was much in the way of untruths that we found, and I therefore I don't think it will ever be found. And that puts that to rest. But now, friends, in our growth, in our walk, we come to find out there's 12 fruits. What are they? Where's the proof of it? Beyond this, well, in our studies, we found the fruits, that they were love. Studying through, it was obvious. Joy, peace, these were the first three anyway in all these different translations. But then we found patience. We found persistence. We found mercy. We found goodness, humility, faith, discipline, wisdom, and honesty. Now, each one of these are specific and not repetitive. They have their own classification, their own meaning. You can be a good person overall in your life, but you may not be very merciful. You may be humble, but you may not have a lot of faith. You may be disciplined, but you may not be joyful. You may have lots of things that you consider love or patience, but you may not be fully honest. Well, we found that these 12 were predominant in our studies. But again, there was no proof. Well, a week ago, as the world calls Sunday, we found and were blessed that day with so much. We Yahuwah helped us to find the truth of how our Savior actually died by way of the Gospel of Peter. And it was a second confirmation of something that happened to us years ago in understanding that Yahuwah turned on, and we found the fruitages of the Spirit, second confirmation, within about an hour of that. The fruitages of the Spirit, the actual proof going way back, was revealed to us as well. And all this in an hour, friends, basically. Can you feel the Ruach, how it works? It was time. Yahuwah had determined that it was time. The night before, I had prayed to Yahuwah. I asked him, please, please, Father, I'd like to provide something to family by way of abundance in food from the Word. And if you would give it to me, I would be so grateful, Father, to share it with the family. And it just came. I wasn't looking for it, friends. It fell in my lap. It fell in my lap because we had had an issue with our computer going down. And so we had to reset a few things, reboot a few things, reinstall a few things. And isn't that something that we do in life as well? We spoke about getting on back on track with Yahuwah. Remember that? Well, this was a way of getting back on track, figuratively and literally. And so Yahuwah gave us this incredible truth. As we were looking through some documents, we happened upon a translation of Bible that I'd never read before. And I started to read through it. And it was the Wycliffe translation. Centuries upon centuries ago, predating King James, predating all this other leavening, all this other yeast that was in the bread of life, polluting it. We found it from Wycliffe back in 1394 AD. This was put together, and we found this truth. It says in that translation, but the fruit, and understand, friends, that this is in a early English, so if it sounds odd, we're going to review this. But the fruit of the Spirit is charit, aioi, peace, patience, long abiding, benignant, goodness, mildness, faith, temperance, continence, chastite, ayin, such things is no law. My jaw dropped. Tears in my eyes. I said, thank you, Father. Thank you, Master, for this truth. Now I have something that I can turn to that predates all this other leavening for our dear brothers and sisters to know. And I can also compare this with what you have given me in reading of your scriptures that we have declared openly about being the true 12 fruits of you by way of our understanding and wisdom that you have given. Well, I decided right then and there I had to compare because it was remarkable. So I started doing so. I looked up the roots of these words, which aren't perfectly clear in a lot of dictionaries, and we had to cross-reference. We had to look at different older dictionaries, and we had to look at Wikipedia, and we compared and encyclopedias, did all these different things to find the truth of these things, the roots of it. We had to look into different aspects of Strong's concordance and so on and so forth. And here we go, friends. Here's what we found. Number one, charit. The word charity of the word or charitable way in modern speak, love. And this was specifically found. And the second one, ioi. I didn't know what that was. It's simply the word of joy translated. Number three, peace, P-E-E-S, of the word peace in translation. Number four, patience. I knew that was patience. We found it. Number five, long abiding, of the word long suffering, or consistently acting in a manner. In modern speak, persistence. Number six, benignite, of the word merciful, or acting in mercy. Number seven, goodness, of the word goodliness, and to piety root word godliness, or better friends, Kanan of Yahuwah, as in goodness. You see? See how that word in the English sense ties into God, that connection of being godlike. Really, we know it as being righteous or walking in a wordful manner, correct? But as the world and in our modern day English, goodness. Number eight, mildness. It's the of the word mildness. In modern speak, the act of being humble or humility. And number nine, faith, of the word faith, right? Clearly. Number 10, temperance, of the word temperance. In modern speak, being disciplined or of having discipline. Number 11, continence, of the word continence. From integrity, i.e. righteous choices or wise choosing in wisdom, you see. Different, you see, friends, in its telling us from the other word as far as being of God, of goodness, you see. There's a difference. One is connected to wisdom, and one is connected to being godlike, if you will. Okay? Number 12, chastit, of the word chastity, synonym of integrity, truthfulness, or quality of being honest, i.e. honesty. And friends, we found the original 12 fruits that confirmed what we have been preaching, that we read nowhere other than the word of Yahuwah, which his Ruach led us to fully and truly understand. Praise Yahuwah. You see how when we compare scriptures with scripture, as it says, as we've read many times in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, that he gives us his set apart wisdom to know the truth of things. It doesn't come from any man who claims to have found hidden scrolls or buried this or has special tie-in with that. No, it comes from where the Ruach leads us. And we knew it before we had any truth of it in actual scripture translation from centuries ago, predating almost all, if not all, scripture that we have today, other than save one or two ancient scrolls that are out there in completion. Well, we have these beautiful things, and they are truly for Yahuwah's people to heal, you see. And we do so just like it says. It says in Revelation 22, and it tells us there's 12, that they're for our healing, that it says his name shall be on their foreheads. That's why Psalms 138:2 says that I bow myself toward your set apart name, Yahuwah. Give thanks to your name for your kindness and your truth, for you have made great your word, your name above all. Which is why he gave his son the name above all names, which is Yahuwah. You see, we use logic. We confirm scripture with scripture. It's not a mystery to Yahuwah's people, only to those whose ears are stopped, whose eyes are covered. Well, praise Yahuwah, because of all these things that he's given, we have an incredible bounty of truth and understanding and blessings. And we recognize that when Yahuwah is speaking to us, we must listen, you see. We must listen, we must take note, we must be aware, we must not discount, but we need to be faithful. That's part of being faithful, testing all things. So friends, for your great health and to our Master, we say in a blessed way, thank you, Father and Master, for this incredible truth of the 12 fruits of the Ruach.
This concludes this seventh day audio broadcast of It's Time for Truth. I'm your servant host, Denya Cajaliero, and you need to know that your comments, suggestions, and support are very, very important to us here. Please send your contact email directly to praiseyahuwah@yahoo.com or go to our contact webpage by clicking on the phone icon at the homepage at www.praiseyahuwah.com. This is the day that Yahuwah has made, so rejoice and be glad in it. Until next week, be a blessing to all and be blessed.